ThingPark Enterprise is Actility's IoT platform, allowing you to build and manage your own enterprise LoRaWAN network from a unique user interface, including sensors, gateways, and data routing, connecting them to all popular clouds and applications. It makes your IoT project secure, simple, and quick to deploy. Let's see how to use it. On the dashboard page, you get a quick overview of the status of your material. On the left, the base station with its four states: active, initialization for when the base station is connecting itself, and the two error states indicating connection or radio issues to address. On the right, same goes for the state of your connected devices. The ThingPark Enterprise platform is divided into three major parts that are essential to building your IoT use case. First of all, you need to connect your gateway to ThingPark. For that, choose yours in the extensive list of compatible manufacturers, such as Cisco, Curlink, Eufy Space, and more. Then select the gateway model, which will allow you to download the documentation guide to understand all the steps you need to take to set up your gateway, as well as to download the corresponding image that you need to install to connect to the network server. In our lab, we are making sure to maintain perfect functioning and compatibility with most of the gateways available on the market, with continuous testing, updating, and debugging. Once your gateway is connected, we can go to the next step, connecting to the visualization platform of your choice. You have two options to create it. Any application can be connected to ThingPark Enterprise thanks to our HTTPS connector, simply by adding your destination URL. Otherwise, on ThingPark X IoT Flow, we have a growing number of connectors available that can transmit the payloads of your devices to platforms such as AWS and Azure IoT Central. Or you can use a more detailed HTTP option using headers in case if you need to use passwords or logins with your connectors. You can also manage the drivers here, which allow to translate your device's data into readable JSON files. We have an extensive and growing list of drivers, but you can always add a new one. Finally, you need to create your devices. Choose the manufacturer in the list and the corresponding model with the right radio region, depending on where it's used. Then you have three important codes to add: the unique identifier, also called DevUI, then the Join AUI or App UI, used in batch for devices of the same type, and the app key. Once those fields are completed, all that's left to do is to select the application you want your device to be connected to. It will send a join request, then connect and start sending its payloads. Once your device is created, you can access its information like status, downlinks and uplinks, radio statistics, and the signal quality. If you scroll down, you can see the last 10 packets of this device, and even see the complete history in the wireless logger, which displays extended information about your device's uplinks and downlinks. Moreover, you can manage your API connection here in order to make calls from other platforms. Go to Help, select DX API Admin, then the Swagger UI of the admin to create a token for secure authentication. This token corresponds to your account and can be renewed anytime. Finally, you will be able to access the DX Core API and make API calls to whichever feature of your ThingPark account you want: devices, base stations, and connections. Now, some more useful tips. In the Manage tab, you can directly access the wireless logger in the Operating Management section, as well as the Network Survey tool. The wireless logger offers you 35 days of data from any device connected to your ThingPark account. You can select a device using its dev UI, set the decoder, and visualize the contents of its payloads, including the MAC information, all the uplinks and downlinks. Additionally, in the Network Survey tool, if you use a device that provides its location, you can set the decoder to Asset Tracker, and then you can find out which exact gateway has transmitted the uplinks by seeing its ID. This way, you can geographically test your network.